Hi, welcome back to my channel. Huh? Why am I dressed up like this? I dress up like this because as you requested. I invited Natsu Dragmeel and the other cast of Fairy Tail to help us in our today's lesson. Do I look like a wizard now? Thanks! I will ask Natsu to teach me how to produce fire. Well, anyway, I'll just remind you that
you can always request an anime that you want me to invite as a guest for our succeeding lessons. Just visit that community tab of our channel and comment your suggestions to my current post there.
Our previous lesson, we learned about coordinating conjunctions. If you failed to watch our video about it, I put its link in the description box below.
By the way, I would like to ask a small favor to you. In order for me to sustain the growth of this channel, please do not skip the ads that will appear in my videos. Thank you for always supporting my hard work in making my video lessons.
Please complete watching our videos up to its end. I always add some activities and seat works at the end part of my videos to help you master the lesson that we are discussing. I also add at the end of the video all the shoutouts as my appreciation for your comments in my videos. Before we proceed to our lesson for today, please like this video as your support to my channel. You can also share this video to your friends. Share the happiness. And most importantly, subscribe if you're not subscribed yet to my channel and hit the notification bell for you to be always updated to new lessons that I will upload here in my channel.
For starters, let's have a spelling. I want you now to get a pen and paper. I'll give you 20 seconds to prepare yourself.
Spelling number one. Spell the word rhinoceros. A rhinoceros is a large, heavily built plant-eating mammal with one or two horns on the nose and thick, folded skin. Example, the name rhinoceros means nose horn and is often shortened to rhino. Two. Spell the word flesh. Flesh is the substance consisting of muscles and fat that is found between the skin and bones of an animal or a human. Example, girls, if someone tries to grab you by the waist, grab his hand immediately. Make sure that your fingers are sinking in his flesh. 3. Spell the word carnivore. Carnivore is an animal that feeds on flesh. Example, carnivores get their energy from eating other animals. 4. Spell circumference. Circumference is the distance around something round or rounded, like the distance around the edge of a circle. Example, the nurse measured the circumference of the newborn baby's head. And then last, number 5, spell the word centimeter. Centimeter is a metric unit of length equal to 1/100 of a meter. Example, a coin circumference is 2 centimeters.
Now, let's check your work. Here's the answer key for our spelling. Done checking? Then, let's move on.
A subordinating conjunction is a word or phrase that links a dependent clause to an independent clause. In our 23rd lesson about types of sentences according to its structure, we learned that a dependent clause does not express a complete unit of thought on its own. It cannot stand as its own sentence, and that it depends upon an independent clause to form a complete idea. If you failed to watch our 23rd video lesson, I put its link in the description box below. The word because is a great way to quickly help you to understand subordinate conjunctions. The word because exists to show you the cause and effect of something, which is essentially what a subordinate conjunction does. On its own, a clause beginning with because is incomplete. Example, because it's the side effect of the mushrooms he ate. We have the sense that there is something missing here. Let's add an independent clause that this statement has something to lean on. Example, strange mushrooms grew on Natsu's head. Now, we will combine the two in a complex sentence. Strange mushrooms grew on Natsu's head because it's the side effect of the mushrooms he ate. There are many subordinate conjunctions to keep track of, but here's a list of some most commonly used. After, although, as, as if, as long as much as soon as though, because, before, even if, even though, if only, if when, if then, in as much, in order that, just as, lest, now since, now that, now when, once, provided that, rather than, since, so that, supposing, then, that, though, till, unless, until, when, whenever, where, whereas, where if, wherever, whether, which, while, who, whoever, why. Question: should I use a comma before a subordinate conjunction? Since a subordinate conjunction connects a dependent clause to an independent clause, the general rule is do not use a comma. Example: Leon was mesmerized by Julia Luxor's beauty after seeing her. In this sentence, we use the subordinate conjunction after to connect the dependent clause to the independent clause. Since the independent clause comes first before the dependent clause, we do not use a comma before the subordinating conjunction after. On the other hand, if the subordinating conjunction and its clause precede the independent clause, use a comma to separate the dependent clause from the independent clause. Before the guild discovered his secret, Loki revealed to Lucy that he's really a celestial spirit. In this sentence, we use the subordinate conjunction before, and we put the dependent clause before the independent clause. This combination of words in the first clause will not form a complete sentence. It will instead make a reader want additional information to finish that clause. That's why we put a comma between the dependent clause and the independent clause. Furthermore, an exemption occurs when the subordinate clause expresses a contrast. Example: Happy can fly, although he's a cat. The subordinate conjunction although was used to express difference between the thoughts within the two clauses. That's why we add comma before the subordinate conjunction although. A cat can fly? Come to think of it. Now, for the subordinate conjunction because, if a sentence will be ambiguous without a comma before because, it is better to insert one and avoid misleading your reader. In other words, the sentence might have double meaning. Example: Sting and Rogue didn't win the Grand Magic Games against Gadgil and Natsu because of the level of their ability. This sentence might imply that Sting and Rogue won against Gadgil and Natsu, but their ability was not the most important contributing factor to their victory. Since there's no comma before because, this sentence will be ambiguous to the reader. The reader will now think, what's the real reason behind Sting and Rogue's victory? But if you've watched Fairy Tales episode 175, you know that Natsu defeats Sting and Rogue single-handedly. So to avoid ambiguity in the sentence, let's insert a comma. Example: Sting and Rogue didn't win the Grand Magic Games against Gadgil and Natsu because of the level of their ability. Now, the reader will understand that Sting and Rogue didn't win against Gadgil and Natsu because the level of their ability is still not enough to defeat them. Did you see the difference now? Again, insert a comma before because only if this might cause the sentence to have double meaning. If not, then don't insert a comma. Remember that a subordinating conjunction is a word or phrase that links a dependent clause to an independent clause. Also, remember that don't insert a comma if the subordinate conjunction was used within the sentence. Add only a comma if the subordinating conjunction was used at the start of a sentence. Thus, we can add a comma between the subordinate clause and independent clause to prevent the sentence to have double meaning whenever we use a subordinate conjunction. Now, let's have an activity. For today's activity, I'm going to read the sentence, then choose the letter of the appropriate subordinating conjunction to complete each sentence. 1. She tried really hard. She lost the race. Which of the following is the appropriate subordinating conjunction to complete the sentence? A. Although. B. Because. C. Since. If your answer is A. Although, then you are correct. 2. Sending everyone the same email, John composed a separate email for each of his friends. Which of the following is the appropriate subordinating conjunction to complete the sentence? A. If only. B. Unless. C. Rather than. If your answer is C. Rather than, then you are correct. 3. I will not talk to her. She comes. Which of the following is the appropriate subordinating conjunction to complete the sentence? A. Even if. B. Although. C. Because. If your answer is A. Even if, then you are correct. 4. I will not go. You come with me. Which of the following is the appropriate subordinating conjunction to complete the sentence? A. Although. B. Whereas. Or letter C. Unless. If your answer is C. Unless, then you are correct. 5. He didn't know what to say. He said nothing. A. Unless. B. Because. C. Though. If your answer is B. Because, then you are correct. 4. For me to know if you really learned in our today's lesson, let's have a sit word. For today's sit word, you're going to choose the appropriate subordinating conjunction in the word bank to combine each pair of sentences. Write your answers on a piece of paper. I'll give you 2 to 3 minutes to do the sit word. If the time is not enough for you, you may pause this video.
Time's up! Let's check your work! Here's the answer key for our today's sit work.
learned a lot in our today's lesson. I hope that now you know all about subordinating conjunctions. Aha! Now I know how to cast a fire spell, all thanks to Natsu. But before I go,
as my means of showing my gratitude and appreciation to all of your comments in my videos, I would like to post a shout out to the following people. Thank you for all of your encouraging and positive comments. Your comments are important to me. By the way, the sole purpose of me making video lessons like this is to help children be able to study at home. So in order for this video to reach as many children at home as possible, please share this video to your friends. And again, to help me be encouraged in making video lessons like this, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click the notification bell as well so that you will always be updated to new lessons that I will upload here in my channel. Thank you and see you in our next video. Bye-bye!